right, we're going to get started. We always like to start on time and recognize that we take, for many of you, your lunchtime away. And so welcome to our somewhat monthly PIC meetings. The topic this month is career and technical education, and Penny just reminded me it was CTE month last February. It's a great time to focus on our career and technical programs as kids are beginning to consider and sign up for CTE programs as well. I think it's one of the areas that we have more and do more than most people know, and so we'd like to bring some awareness to that opportunity that's out there. And certainly the career technical education field continues to grow and more opportunity in our state. And so the emphasis is pretty heavily from the state level down through Midland Public Schools on career technical education. Tracy Gerstheimer, speaker, oversees that area for us. And so I'm gonna turn it over to Tracy and you can lead the show.
So I'm just going to provide a very broad overview of our programs today, and then we'll have the pleasure of hearing from students who are involved in the programs, because I think they sell it better than I ever can. So we'll start with something very basic, and that is defining what is CTE. So the definition on the right is from the state of Michigan, and there's three key phrases within that definition. CTE programs prepare today's students for a wide range of high wage, high skill, high demand careers. Those are the three key phrases. It's different from when I was in school and we had vocational ed programs, and we'll talk a little bit about how it's different throughout this presentation. In the nation, there are 17 career clusters. In that small diagram on the left, you'll see there's quite a range of programming, from manufacturing to hospitality, all different kinds of programs. A school or a district typically does not offer all 17. What we do instead is we focus on what is in demand in our state and in our region, and we try to align our programs to meet those needs in the market. So specifically, what does MPS offer? These are the six pathways that we offer. You can see they're really broad. There are some handouts over on the table there behind Penny and Kim that have a description of each one. So if there's a particular pathway that you want to know more about, grab one of the handouts and it will give you all the industry certifications, a little description of each program, because there's a lot of different programs within these sort of umbrella pathways. So why are they important? This is something I feel really passionately about. One of the things that's really different about career and tech ed is our teachers. Not only are they expected to prepare students to learn the technical skill, to teach them how to weld or care for patients or build something, they're also expected to teach them employability skills. So this could be resume building, this could be interviewing skills. Those things are important for every student to experience. Also, students get an opportunity to explore something hands-on. One of the things I think that's interesting in high school is we ask students, what do you want to be? What do you want to be when you grow up? And a lot of times they don't know. And that never surprises me, because you often don't know what you want to do until you try something. And then you say, oh, I really enjoyed that, I want to do this. Or you say, no, that's not for me. But those experiences are really valuable to try it out, and our programs give students that opportunity. There's a lot of research and data to show us that students in programs have a higher graduation rate. Once you identify something you're interested in, you're motivated to come to school and do it. And for many students, this might be the reason they want to go to school. They might not enjoy their English class, painful as that may be to me, they enjoy their CTE class, whatever that may be. And then students can earn industry certifications. So when you graduate from high school, if you have an industry certification, you're immediately employable. You can go work in your field and gain valuable experience and hours in that area, which you can apply to decide what you want to do later. And some of our students are already doing something like this, and they're going to talk about that. And then lastly, I had to put something in here about fact versus fiction. You know, there's a lot of old ideas about CTE, and I just wanted to put them up front, that CTE, or vocational ed as it used to be called, is only for students who are not going to college. That's not true, it's for everyone, and you're gonna hear different experiences from our students. Currently, 53% of Midland Public students are in a CT class right now. So chances are your son, your daughter, will take one class at some point during their 4 years in high school. It's something that everyone can participate in. Old idea that CTE pathways are low skill, not so. Our pathways use science, technology, and math, so much so that the state of Michigan says we will allow you to fulfill certain graduation requirements if you take this course. So if you're in engineering, you can get a year credit of math. If you're in agro science, you can get a year of science credit. Every program has some possibility like that. CTE programs are for men, right? There's some old ideas about who works in certain fields, and you're gonna hear from some students who are breaking those ideas down. And our teachers specifically target students who aren't necessarily who we first think of would work in that particular field. That's one of the goals of a CTE program. Pathways are terminal. That's an old idea. The idea that the student would participate in the program and that would be it. They wouldn't go on to college. They wouldn't go get additional training from their employer. They wouldn't go to a community college to pursue something, right? That's an old idea. All of our programs have some type of articulation agreement, so students can earn credits if they take accounting, for example. Get credit, college, it transfers over so they're not starting over in accounting. Welding, over and over. And that the pathways are low wage, and so there is a document over there that I would love to talk about for an hour, really, but I can't. It's called the Hot Jobs List for Michigan. And so every few years, Michigan studies this as well as other states, and they put out a document that says, here are the jobs that are projected to have the greatest growth until 2030. And I invite you to grab a copy at some point and look at it. You'll see a range of different jobs there and different education and training required for them. And starting salaries, and there's a lot of variety there, a lot of opportunity for students. All right, that is my brief overview, because I'm not the exciting part. These guys are the exciting part. So I wanted to start with first saying, thanks for being here. It's always a little strange to do these things, right? Could you please, and we can start maybe with Amber, introduce who you are, tell us what grade you are, and what program you represent today. Push the button so it goes green. There you go, awesome.
All right. Testing, okay, it works. All right, so I'm Amber Curry. I participated in Healthcare and Tech 1 my junior year. I'm now a senior at Dow High. Is there anything else I need to cover with this question?
You got it, those are the three things to start with. Who you are, what you're doing, what your grade is.
I'm Daniel Charters. I'm a senior at Dow High School and I participate in automotive technology.
I'm Gavin Painter. I'm a senior at Dow High also, and I'm also in the automotive technology class.
My name is Grayson Moore. I am a junior at Midland High School, and I am in the building trades program.
My name is Isaac Ringgold. I'm a sophomore at Midland High School, and I'm part of the welding program.
Hi, my name is Sophia Reed, and I'm part of the building trades program.
I'm Lars Larson. I'm also part of the Building Trades program.
My name is Stephen Hackbarth. I'm a senior at Midland High School, and I participate in the Business CTE program.
Hi, my name is Ellie Sinkowski. I'm a junior at Dow High, and I also participate in the Business CTE course.
My name is Craig Hurst. I'm in 10th grade at Midland High, and I participate in the Engineering program.
I'm Abigail Good. I'm a junior at Dow High, and I participate in the engineering program.
Hi, I'm Lindsay Campbell. I am a senior at Midland High School, and I am also in the building trades program.
So I'm gonna have you keep it, and we're gonna have a question of why. Why did you decide to take your first CTE class? What drew you to that area?
I really enjoy hands-on work. And so my teacher kind of pushed me towards building trades, and so I was like, okay, I'll try it. And this is actually my second year doing building trades, and I just absolutely love it.
I joined the engineering program because I always enjoyed doing things with my dad that are engineering-like and different sorts of building.
I joined the engineering program because I've been interested in engineering for many years, and I was recommended by a lot of people to take the course because there's a lot of hands-on learning, social skills, aside from the engineering portion of it.
So I chose to become a part of the business CTE my freshman year because I wasn't really sure what I wanted to go into, especially in high school when there's so many different options to take. So I was told by some of my friends who had already completed their freshman year that they really enjoyed taking the business CTE courses, and I decided I'd try it out, and I really liked it and decided to stick with it through now.
Yeah, so I had a similar experience where before going into high school, I wasn't very sure what I was passionate about or what I wanted to go into, and I saw that marketing was an option to take my freshman year, and I thought, hey, I'll just try it out and see what happens. I knew that I was always one of those people in math class that would be like, man, when am I ever going to use this, right? You hear that a lot. And so I tried something that was a little more hands-on, and I fell in love with it, so I decided to take business classes throughout my entire high school career. So.
So this would be my sixth year of taking wood shop, so I guess just building trades would be the next step to, I guess, continue that interest in that.
I also did wood shop last year as well, and I really enjoyed it, and I really wanted to do the next step as well in building trades. Just seemed like a great opportunity.
I chose to take the welding course at Midland High because I always used to work with my grandpa in the summer. He's a contractor, and I really enjoy hands-on work, and I thought, oh, welding would be fun, so I decided to take it this year.
So I decided to take the building trades course because I wanted to even know if I was interested in the trades, and being able to know that opportunity before I'm even out of high school can save me some years of even deciding if I like trades or not. And even more important, I decided if I even like what trade I wanted to take. I thought I wanted to take electrical, but now I'm more leaning towards framing and being a contractor.
Mm-hmm. I joined Auto Tech because I've just always been interested in cars. I bought my first car at 13. And
you couldn't drive it, though.
But I also took car care last year, which just kind of like made me think, yeah, this is something I want to do. Mm-hmm.
I took Auto Tech because I enjoy working with my hands, and I always was interested to see how things work.
I took Healthcare Tech because I didn't really know what I wanted to do, but I've been put in medical situations where I get this adrenaline rush, which is pretty addicting when you have something that you can say, I came out on the other side of this, so I decided that I was going to give Healthcare Tech a shot and see what it would do.
So I'm going to pose the next question, and everyone doesn't have to answer it. We can kind of popcorn as appropriate, right? So you have an opportunity to share, you know, what do you wish parents or students knew about your particular program, right? There's lots of misconceptions about what the program is like. What, if you've got a moment to tell them, what would you like to tell them?
I just wanted to talk a bit about, like, the differences in, I saw it with my own parents, but differences between educational philosophies in general. So a lot of the times we see parents, if your student is not doing well in math or a class that's like normal outside of the CTE program, so many times we are like, okay, why did you fail your chemistry test? Why didn't you do well in this math test? But what I would like more parents to know is that if you find out what your kid is passionate about and you ask them, okay, what made you look forward to going to school this day? Like, what projects were you working on in this specific class? You can find out what they're actually passionate about, and instead of trying to like fit a square peg into a round hole, you can just like learn more about your kid and what they like, so.
Yeah. Somebody else want to take it?
So kind of going off what you said, especially if you find out what your kid's passionate about, like, for example, in my case, if you're passionate about business, it's not just sitting in a classroom learning about skills. You actually have the opportunity to go into a real-world situation and apply those skills. And I took the class my freshman year. I learned about those skills. I started slowly working in our school store and being able to actually apply them and see how much of a difference that they can make. And it's really made me more, like, more enjoyable to go to school because I have something that I like and I get to constantly be doing something hands-on that I've been able to apply skills I've previously learned.
I also have something to say around those lines, even though I'm not really in the whole business thing. But even with healthcare and tech, I feel like there's this big stereotype that maybe you might become a CNA or a nurse and you're going to call it good. I feel like the healthcare tech program has good building blocks to become a doctor or a surgeon or whatever you'd like to do in the hospital, or even not in the hospital, home healthcare or in just a regular physician's clinic office. So, I mean, it's you take good skills with you wherever you go. So, I mean, you also get to see what you want to do or what you don't want to do. Because healthcare is you're really in it or you're really not. So.
That would make sense. One thing I found is that whenever I recommend someone to join the engineering course or to take an engineering course, they're always like, oh, I don't know if I do, or I don't know much about that, or I don't know, I don't think I'd do good because I don't have no prior knowledge. And you don't need that. In order to join any of the CTE courses, you don't have to have that prior knowledge. It's a great way to expand your knowledge and to just learn what you might like in the future, too.
So going a little bit off that, for building trades, I wish people knew how easy being able to start going on this is. Even if you just know how to read a tape measure, if you just start learning, you will know how to build a house from the foundation. And for me, just a year ago, I was in woodworking making a cardboard, like making a cutting board. And now this year, I've already have some businesses reaching out to me for a summer job. And even for not even people who are looking to go into the trades industry, just people who want to learn about building a house, because everybody here after high school is going to be a homeowner. We will all know how to build a house and just basic needs instead of having someone come to your house and build it for you would be way cheaper instead of, like, yeah. You can save some money.
For sure.
So going off of what some other people have said, any student is going to learn so much more than they would have thought in these programs. So for example, for me, I'm in the Principles of Engineering class, and we learn just about the basics of engineering, but we also learn how to conduct professional interviews. We learn how to become a leader in group projects. We do a lot of group projects. Almost nothing is done individually. And we learn how to go into the real world, into the fields, and study equipment, and research those, talk to professionals about what they do, and learn from them, and which is a lot more than I would have thought that I was going to learn going into these classes initially.
Mm-hmm. All right. I speak for myself here, and I think for a few other trades. There's typically a lot of stereotypes around trades programs, such as if you're not the best student, like, oh, maybe you should go into the trades. If in society now, most of our school is based off of STEM, a lot of math and science courses. But we still need people to go into the trades to help work because they build our economy up from the ground. They're the ones who are starting these businesses and who are helping humans and people to actually thrive in our economy. And I think that a lot of people also think that there's stereotypes around, or going back to the grades and stuff, people aren't always, there's stereotypes that people aren't always the smartest that go into the trades programs. And I think that's not the truth, because I know a lot of smart, really smart people who are in the trades. And everyone in the community is super good in the trades, so. Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure if it's like this for the rest of the CTE programs, but a lot of colleges have come in and talked to us, and I feel like they do a really good job setting you up for the rest of your life, because they'll get you into colleges or other trade schools. They've also had like military come in and talk to us, and then those colleges also will set you up with other jobs. So
for me in auto tech, I can learn so much more than just auto. I've learned to weld, and I've learned a little bit about residential electric, and that's just kind of skimming the surface about other things than auto I can learn.
So why don't we talk a little bit about what your future plans are? You may not know, right? But some of you do know. So if you know, please share with us. And some of you are already working through work-based learning experiences. So maybe talk about that a little bit as well.
So for me, I co-op at Garber, the Chevrolet dealership. And my confidence in my work and my knowledge have just grown in general.
So I actually have a really cool job, which is working at the hospital on the medical oncology floor. Everyone else's jobs are cool too, but this was a little different to say. I mean, I get all sorts of patients that I see on the daily. I actually work on the floors with nurses, with CNAs. I do everything from bedpan, showers. I've gotten so much from this job. So I plan on actually going into nursing for college, and I've gotten some pretty good scholarships and good colleges trying to come and get me to go there because I have worked in a hospital at the age of 17, which is extremely rare. Mm-hmm. And so it gives you, the CTE courses give you that good building block, and they also give you opportunities to co-op for most of us, so.
So even though I'm in building trades, I plan to go to school for a degree in business management. So I think someone said that just because you're in the program doesn't mean that's what you have to do, but I think like the auto care and the welding and the trades, it just sets you up for being out like on your own in the real world, even though you might not want to pursue that career path.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I'm going to be attending Northwood University as a part of the accelerated MBA program with a focus on marketing. But through the CTE, like the business course at least, you get to test a lot of different options. It starts with, like, I did marketing, but I also did advanced business, accounting, computer tech, all of those various courses. So there's just a lot of options, but I finally decided to focus on marketing, and I was given a lot of scholarships because of my involvement in the CTE program. So
I'm just not in building trades. I'm also in the POE program as well. So I'm actually going to SVSU next year in the engineering courses, specifically mechanical engineering, mm-hmm. which is more like auto tech, but we don't have that at Midland High, so I'm doing building trades. But I'm also going to be doing summer jobs and working at construction sites while I'm also at college as well.
I'm co-oping right now at the Midland Ford dealership, and I'm in the quick lane right now, which I'm just doing basic stuff, but I feel like that's also a really good place to build up, just learning all the basic stuff before you actually get into the big shop and do all the actual car stuff. Mm. So,
yeah.
I'm also going to college at Ohio Tech. So,
I'm in Principles of Engineering right now, and in the future I want to study aeronautical and aerospace engineering. And even though at Midland High, we really focus on mechanical, electrical, and programming, still all those concepts come together pretty much for every single engineering field, and there are a lot of them. But we really study those three basic ones, which are able to be applied to almost every single field, which I definitely feel very prepared to do so.
So right now I am a junior taking building trades, and next year I will be co-oping at Orvash Builders, and I'll be able to get the upper hand on being able to know what a actual construction business will be able to do. And then in the summer, I might be doing a summer job this year. And then after high school, I do plan on still working with that business.
I'm in the engineering design and development class at Dow High, and we really focus on how it's going to be like in the future and what's going to be like at an actual job. And it's really prepared me. It's helped me make real world connections with mentors that are outside our school district and professional connections and different types of stuff. And I want to be an electrical engineer, hopefully go to Michigan Tech.
I plan to, when I get out of high school, go to college and study welding engineering.
My plan is to go to Ferris State University, and I actually took a tour and got to see like the program that they have and everything that we'll be doing in the next 4 years. And building trades actually really prepared me for that, because a lot of the hands-on stuff that they have now, I have already learned here. So I'm really excited for that.
So can you all talk about some of the things that you've done in class that helped you prepare for your workforce experiences? So your teachers do a lot of things in this area. Maybe you can talk about some of the highlights.
I would say we do a lot of hands-on learning, and as I'm a manager, I get to do a little bit more than some of the typical students, but I definitely know what it's like to be a student, so I have some experience in that. We do a lot of like contacting businesses as I'm part of the business CTE and working with it, and the main role of our teacher is just to advise us. So my current advisor used to be a marketing executive at colleges and different sports facilities, so he has been able to teach us a lot about like how to actually market in the real world and how to target specific target audiences. And I've been able to really further my skills and being able to like have professional conversations, contact people, talk with people that aren't necessarily always the happiest with us if we've had like issues, and just kind of like dealing with that side of it. So it's not always just like parents are loving us. So I've been able to have a lot of great experience dealing with both sides of customers, which has been really valuable to me. And even though I'm not like interested in going to the business field, I've been able to gain a lot of valuable experience from that.
Yeah, so I'm also a manager of my school store. And through that, there's been so much hands-on learning, like in all different areas. Like I was given a spreadsheet and told I got to do the accounting. So I figured out how to do that. And that was really a valuable learning experience. The teacher, Mrs. DeBoer, who's at Midland High for all of the business programs, as well as Dr. Kronk, they are both like some of the best teachers I've ever had, and have really work with you and know what you're skilled at and put you in positions to learn a lot hands-on. I've helped design the clothing for the store. We put on a fashion show, all sorts of projects like that the student is entirely responsible for creating the actual content for. So
as far as building trades, I'm also in the marketing class as well. And one big thing we just did is the RSI, the Ready Set Interview. So all of, I don't know what other classes, but all the marketing classes went. Everybody dressed up like you're going to a job interview, and we all went to Davenport. And the trades classes did too. I think that was a big thing to really prepare people for going out to get jobs and having like real interviews and being able to experience that when like the time actually comes to get a job.
And another thing with building trades is that you're not just building a house and doing the framework, you're doing everything inside. We have also done electrical as well and had hands-on experience with a actual professional. And we've also gotten to do a whole bunch of other stuff that you might not even know that we do, like cabinetry, we do the siding, everything you see on that house we have done and had hands-on experience with. And we've also had a trades fundraising night, which a lot of people, like business owners and people who own construction sites and stuff like that, come in and we can meet them, and DOTA can give in a good word, and we can even get a lot of like job opportunities from that as well.
So the welding program is a little bit different. We're not really allowed to work on personal projects anymore, so there isn't really a way to get that outside world experience in. I know that in welding 2 and welding 3, there are other projects that you will work on, but basically it's just basic, the fundamentals of welding, so stick, MIG, and TIG. And you do basic joints, basic welds, and then I think welding 3, you start doing more advanced pipe welding. You can go into other courses. And I know there are, she mentioned the building trades banquet, and that was a good way to really get out there and talk to some people about getting jobs and hands-on experience and getting mentorships and working to become part of the workforce.
So also for building trades, yes, we do learn how to build a house, but our teacher, Mr. Dodick, also gives us the responsibility of having to do something instead of always watching us. He does tell us to go cut this thing or go build this side of the house or do something, and gives us that responsibility of having to do it ourselves and being able to build it without him thinking we're going to mess up or do something wrong.
Yeah, responsibility.
Yep.
One of the things that came to mind for me is that our teacher hits safety really hard at the beginning of the year just to make sure that everybody's using lifts correctly. We all know where all the fire safety stuff is. And another thing is that he also rewards us for bringing our skills that we learned from the auto tech out into the actual world. Like, I was able to test out of my exam by taking the state electrical certification test for automotive.
Yeah. My teacher in my program right now, he has been in the engineering field for many years, and he has been able to push us to become more and more independent in our learning. He has taught us how to find our own resources, whether online or with other people. We have learned how to be presented with a problem, and then either individually or as a group, we have been able to discuss the problem, go through the design process, and then come up and develop a successful solution. And a lot of the times that is without the help of a teacher, but that is later in the year as we learn to become more independent.
For auto tech, the amount of miscellaneous work once we get all of our in school work done, I've been building a flatbed using a plasma cutter and welding, and I also took my certification test, and we've been preparing for skills competitions, so the amount of extra work we can do in auto tech.
One thing that's really nice about the engineering course and the CTE courses in general is that our teachers like to teach us the skills we need to succeed. It's very much work-based learning, and it's very self-paced, but it's up to the student to continue the project. However, our teachers will teach us technical writing, how to make professional connections, how to address an audience, public speaking. They teach us the skills we need to succeed, and then kind of guide us as we practice those skills throughout the year.
In healthcare tech, we actually learned how to take blood pressure and vitals with an actual, like, the manual way, not the vitals cards way, but the manual way with a blood pressure cuff and a stethoscope. And everyone got one to take home. You could do it on your parents, your grandparents. You can blow their arm up as many times as you want. Just do it the right way. We went around the school pestering other teachers, which that was pretty cool. We also learned how to transfer people from bed to wheelchair, weight on the old-fashioned scales where you push the little thing, you know, and hopefully it's accurate. We also learned how to do CPR. We learned basically the building, like I say building blocks a lot, but it's a first step into the medical field with all of these basic things that you will do no matter what you become. So, I mean, vitals, transferring, bathing, hygiene, for like oral hygiene. So there was so many different skills that we got to learn because the classroom actually had like a hospital bed in it with wheelchairs and scales and all of those other things that you needed for vitals. So it was pretty useful.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So part of CTE programs have students participate in different leadership organizations. So maybe talk a little bit about your experiences with that or how you have evolved as a leader as you've participated in the program.
I know that before this year, I was always inspired by people that would really take the lead in things that they were passionate about, but I never saw myself as somebody that could do it until this year, where I was told that like I could be a manager of the school store and I could help schedule kids and lead shifts within the store, as well as like lead the fashion show and run all these sort of things where I have complete creative control over. And that process has grown, like my leadership skills have grown so much because I learned how to delegate. I learned like how to put your own ego aside and realize what other people are good at and putting them in positions to help you succeed. And as well as learning how to be more selfless as a leader. A lot of the times you can think when you're in a leadership position that it's all about you and that like it's your outcome is going to be determined by your work. But a lot of the times, if you can find what motivates people, if you can find how to get a team all motivated by their own individual, motivations, then you'll be able to succeed as a unit. So,
I want to say leadership skills as far as the medical field is pretty different because you're working your way up in it. But there is some really helpful things that I took with me to work in the hospital where you are presented with different situations all the time and you have to think fast and quick and you don't have a chance to doubt yourself. You need to do it and you need to do it now. So, I mean, just finding that confidence to do what I needed to do with my patients, that was very helful. So I would say it's pretty much of a leadership role though, because you have this person's life and health in your own hands. And sometimes it's up to you to make sure that you do it right and this person has a good shot.
So I was brought in as store manager my sophomore year. And when I came in, I was very timid and very shy and I was the youngest person out of all of them. And I even thought about quitting because I did not want to talk to these people. I did not want to be put in a situation where I had to order my peers around. And I was really nervous going into it. And through my experience last year and this year, I can definitely tell a change in myself and my own confidence ability and having more confidence in the set of skills that I can bring to other people and just being able to work with my peers with no nervous thoughts at all. Now going into it, it feels so comfortable. I actually thoroughly enjoy working with them and being able to kind of have this leadership position at our school. And it has definitely allowed me to gain the skills and confidence I need to go into other leadership positions in our school, and it's definitely prepared me for the future.
Like I said earlier, my confidence and knowledge in general has just grown. So I feel like I can confidently help out other students that may need it, or raise my hand and answer questions in class, whereas before I really didn't feel like I could.
For the engineering program or the engineering capstone class, we don't really have leadership positions in there. We have our own groups where we work together as a team. But one thing I've really learned throughout all the engineering courses is teamwork, because I was not great at group projects and just group work in general. I don't think most people like them or enjoy working in large groups. Yeah. But I really learned to enjoy having other people to bounce ideas off, and I learned the advantages of working with other people and how to work with other people to advance your own projects and your own work.
Going off what Daniel said before, I feel like my confidence in automotive knowledge has just improved a lot more also. Like, I feel like if someone asked me how many volts about like a car battery had or how a suspension worked in a car, I wouldn't know. But now I actually like gain the knowledge to like be able to confidently tell people how that works.
Mm-hmm. So being a leader isn't exactly my forte, but in building trades, I am one of the few students who have done this process already, so I'm a second year. And so I am able to answer some questions that the kids have regarding different types of projects that we're doing. It's to the best of my ability, anyways.
So for building trades, being able to learn about the different types of a house also boosts my confidence. And for me, I am an extrovert. I do want to talk and have interactions with people. So if I do know how to build something, I want to go and teach that person how to do it as well and make sure everybody knows the correct way how to do it. So for me, that's kind of the leadership.
Yeah.
Welding has taught me a lot in the sense of being confident in my ability to do something and being a leader and helping other students in class who might not understand what's actually going on, how to weld this, and stuff like that. And I want to mention all of our teachers who have helped us grow and learn and become the best students we possibly can and have taught us how to be this confident and taught us our trade, basically.
So some of you have industry certifications already, or you're about to earn an industry certification. So if that applies to you, I'd like you to just tell our audience a little bit about what that means and what you've done, what you've accomplished.
So right now, I also go to Delta. I'm dual enrolled. In order to work at the hospital, you have to be dual enrolled. So I am actually working on getting my CNA license right now. So I'm in a CNA class currently. I'll be doing clinicals. I work with in the lab a lot, very hands-on. And so by the time I graduate, I have the opportunity to go and take the state board test to get CNA certified, and I can work while I'm in college as a CNA at almost any hospital I would like to. So it's very nice to be able to get that head start and know that I will most likely have job security while I'm in college.
Yeah.
For me, I'm already mechanic certified by the state of Michigan. So like she said, the job security after I graduate, and currently I'm the youngest certified technician in Garber.
Woohoo.
So, like Daniel, I'm also certified in certain things. I went into the SOS, all that fun, took the test, and I know you have your electrical. I have my electrical, brakes, and suspension certifications for Michigan, and I'm also the youngest certified mechanic at Midland Ford.
So all three of us, me, Sophia, Grace, I guess four, and Lindsay, so we're all OSHA 10 trained, so like ladders and enclosed pits and like all the construction site safety. And then also for marketing, I have like the basic workplace safety training for like private information, like people's like their credit cards and stuff like that, or like doors, like security doors and stuff you have in your workplace, and also the active shooter training. I took that, so when I go out to get a job, I already have that experience for, like, those certain things that you'd want to have at your workplace.
I got certified through computer tech, which is part of the business CTE emphasis. I got my Microsoft certification, so that's showing proficiency in Microsoft Excel, Word, and those tests would usually cost you about $100 because certain jobs, whether it be anything from data entry to data science, you need those certifications to get a job, and that would normally cost you, I think it's $100 or $200 to take it, and that's offered free by the school the first time you take the test. So that's valuable to get from those classes, and like Lars said, you get OSHA training and that kind of thing, so conflict resolution.
So my last question is, let's say you have a freshman in front of you, they don't know what they want to do, right? What advice would you give them?
100% just try new things. Like, it can be scary a lot of the time, where if you have this feeling like, oh, everyone else knows exactly what they want to do. Nobody does. You just got to try things. It doesn't matter how old you are. It's like, you're always finding yourself. So just try something hands-on and get out there.
So I would also say I 100% agree, because the most like thing that I get told is that I don't like business, and neither do I, but it has given me a lot of skills that have helped me, because I know that I do not want to go into business. I don't want to be like working in that field, but the skills that has given me and the opportunities that I've had to like grow my skills and grow my confidence level and work with my peers has been something that nothing else in the school has been able to give me, and it is a really important course that is different than all the other ones, and I highly recommend it to anyone.
Okay, all right. So I wanted to leave some time for our audience members who may have questions for our student panelists. Now is that time. Is there anything you want to know from them?
Full disclosure, I'm the president of the Home Builders Association, so I'm biased in the builder and trade direction a little bit. So it was nice to hear that some of you appreciated the Building Trades fundraiser. We thought that went really well this year, and we're glad to do that. And we're doing something else in the fall, so it'll be next school year. That's not set in stone yet, but we plan on doing something, maybe like a cornhole tournament, where we'll have a chance for students to be basically mingling more with contractors in a way they can talk with business owners and contractors in the building community here in Midland. So so that'll be going on too, and we'll obviously let everybody know, whoever's still going to be around. And I had some questions, but honestly, you guys did great. Like, I'm not going to expound on that too much. I think you did a wonderful job. And the only thing I'd say is that, again, with that slight building trades bias, that there is a lot of progress and things to do to be made in the building trades, like right now. And you business and engineering students, don't be afraid to like consider that as an angle to contribute. And as a person who went to Delta CMU in residential construction and construction management, business is not to be overlooked. Like, you just bump into it everywhere. Mm-hmm. I could have stood to have more training in the business realm. So. Thank you. I don't really have a question beyond that. Thank you. I just wanted to say I appreciated this.
I want to applaud each one of you for taking the choice that you've chosen. I mean, it's wonderful. It's exciting. It's really exciting to see. I graduated from Midland High in 71, and I still don't know what I want to do. I'm kind of like you. Yeah. Where am I going? Mm-hmm. But, you know, I mean, you are going to, what you've chosen is going to be vital to our economy, like you were talking about. You said we're vital to the economy and our society, and I really, really appreciate it. And the older I get, the more I realize how vital you people are going to be. So thank you very much for sharing, and I'd just like to encourage you to keep plugging it, you know, keep bringing PR, and I thank the school system for doing this too. My dad was on the school board umpteen years ago, and this was, when I graduated, it wasn't even a thing. Mm-hmm. So I really, really, really appreciate what you're doing. Thank you for sharing, too. You all did a wonderful job up there, so appreciate it. And thank you to Mr. Cheryl here and you and everything else for implementing this program. Appreciate it very much.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Yes.
That this gave you as a student, as preparing you for your future, whatever that might be. How can MPS encourage CTE? So like, do you have ideas for how to get the word out to more students that this is an option?
Mm-hmm.
That we have this really awesome, robust, amazing program.
I would say one idea I have is to implement it in the middle schools. Because a lot of clubs I know go to like the eighth grade class at the end of the year and kind of tell them like, hey, you should join our club. And I think it'd be a really great opportunity for the CTE courses to have some kind of like the similar opportunity that you can go and talk to them, especially since a lot of like incoming freshmen have no idea what they want to do. They don't know what's offered at high school. They're not sure what to take, especially since there's so many electives that they can take now. And just having like more information on, hey, I might be interested in that. I should check that out. And just having someone that they can talk to about it.
Yeah, so one of the things I've noticed with the healthcare and tech program is that last year there was 2 hours of this class because we had enough students, and now there's only one. And another thing is that it was kind of underground, to be honest, when I saw it. I heard about it once my sophomore year, and I kept it in the back of my mind. And since COVID and being in the healthcare field, I get it. It's scary. It's not going to be, like, the greatest time ever if you think about it. But honestly, I think we should try to, any way we can, really put it out there more, because there are so many people, like, even, like I said, surgeons, doctors, no matter whatever you want to be, as long as it's in the medical field, I think that this is a great program for it.
So I don't remember when it was, but we had, like, the career day, I think it was for all the sophomores at Midland High. I think I never got to go because of COVID, so I really didn't know about it. But I think it'd be maybe a better opportunity if more grades got to go than just sophomores, so then you know about it sooner, and then you can take, like, if you want to go into business, you can take it 3 years instead of two, or, you know, all, like, the wood shop or the engineering. You can have those classes earlier in high school.
Yeah, what, like she was saying, how it was kind of underground when she found it. I feel like a lot of incoming freshmen don't really know about the CTE programs, and they don't really understand that the programs count towards other credits for graduating. And I feel like really explaining that taking those classes will give you those extra credits without actually having to take, like, an art class, or you'll be able to take another math class, and you'll also be able to take another CTE program, so you get 2 years of that math credit out of the way. If you're not necessarily the best at whatever class you want to take, you can take a CTE program. So really just uprooting it and making sure that people understand that the programs are actually valuable, and they're not just programs that you take because, like, oh yeah, I want a free hour for a class.
I've actually had this idea in the back of my head for a bit, if like building trades and welding can join together with marketing, because we do have building trades, like gear, like hoodies, hats. I think that'd be great to sell at Chemet Corner, or the equivalent of what Dow has, because of course we're teenagers, we love to wear, like, cool stuff in our clothes, and a lot of people look at what you're wearing, and I think it'd be a great way to kind of spread that around the school and kind of give it a little bit more voice, because those, like, the trades are very underground even now with it being a little bit bigger. I feel like not as many people know about it, and kind of having that, like, kind of billboards on almost everyone would be amazing to have
everyone kind of see those.
And about what Ellie said too, like, at the middle school level, I feel like that's a great opportunity to sort of, from a cultural perspective, I think that we need to, like, legitimize CTE as up there with, like, AP in the, or IB, in the sense that, like, this can count towards college credit. There's no reason that it should be treated differently culturally, but it is within our school. So I think that teachers outside of the CTE program need to keep it, like, put it on the pedestal that it deserves. So yeah, that's pretty much it.
Hey Tracy, can you go back to your fact fiction part of it? So actually the number one blocker in CTE is parents' perceptions. So not to turn it around a little bit, kiddos, but we the biggest blocker in continuing larger enrollment is perception that all kids need to go off to college, and we want all kids to go where some of us had success, and that's university bound. And so that world's shifting quickly. Universities know that. They're starting to fear for their livelihood as all these other career opportunities and different paths to valuable careers are occurring. So to that question, I think that's one that's really important. The other thing I think I'd like to point out is Midland is a great county, but one of the unusual things in Midland County is we are one of the few counties in the state that does not have a CTE millage or a CTE center. And so Midland Public Schools for years operated in a silo on its own and offered these programs. And I have to give a counterpart that's now retired out of Coleman. When I first arrived here, she really wanted us to work together as a county and offer programs across. And she was starting up the ag program in Coleman. And so now we should allow our students to shift throughout the school districts. We still offer 9 of you know, 90% of the programs here in Midland Public being the largest district, but there are opportunities where we send students to Coleman for ag or other locations as well. And you saw we had a little mix in this group, but I also saw still the bias of we don't have auto at Midland High and we don't have welding. We want kids to cross town and we'll need that to continue to go. That's hard to do, I know, but yet we have to break that barrier down because we're never going to be quite the size where we're going to be able to offer an auto on each side of the town or welding on each side of town or building trades. And they get labeled a little bit as such as building trades as Midland High program. No, not. It's supposed to be open to all. I don't know if we, you know, some of the years we have a little success getting kids to cross, but not always. And I'll just add, you added bias to the building trades, and I'll add bias to the auto guys, just so you know, because I might have been the only certified mechanic as a superintendent in the state, so I grew up in your field.
So Mr. Sharo stole half of my question. Okay. As a horticulturalist and somebody who very much has a passion for ag, most of you said that answer that you didn't know or it was underground. Were you aware of culinary arts opportunities elsewhere, or were you aware of Coleman Ag opportunities?
There's, I would say, three parts to CTE that are really, like, they're not promoted nearly enough as they should be, and that's the agri-science, the education. You can go to Bullet Creek and I think it's daycare. I have friends that co-op with that. So it's the agri-science, the culinary, and the education that is really not talked about as much. So communicating that those opportunities are there and legitimizing those pathways as well is important.
And then the barrier of that. And so we do pretty well with ag. Mm-hmm. We send quite a few students in ag, but when the culinary moved to Coleman, we saw a decrease in enrollment from MPS immediately for the distance or the perception of going out to Coleman. And so we have to, like crossing town, as well as going to other buildings, we have to break down that barrier on sending them. Bullet Creek has the same issue of sending kids into our welding or some of those programs. I'd like to go into welding, but I don't really want to travel over to Midland High. And so we have those issues throughout the county. Penny, this is actually her background. And so she can probably speak to a little bit about some of the county stuff that occurs. But we do have support from our ESA that you have to through county. And Don Johnson, this is the coordinator for the county as well.
Mm-hmm. I was going to say that today is the competition for FFA, the state competition. Yes. Yes. So there were students that I wanted to participate in that program, but they could not be here.
Yes, they're all on campus. I was on campus the last 2 days.
Show of hands question, and just like baseline, like how many of you think you were aware of CTE as like a pathway in middle school? Okay. And do you think it would be helpful in terms of awareness if there was more awareness made, obviously not so much classes, but just awareness of the made perhaps at a middle school level? Maybe
I was told by the counselors that those classes were probably not going to run because there's not enough students. But now that has completely shifted because now way more, because we have more business teachers and teachers in general that are in the CTE program. Like there's so much more of an emphasis. So I think it'll happen over time, but definitely more promotion needs to be done in the middle school level.
I don't know how many of you guys went through the Project Lead the Way curriculum because we were kind of starting when you probably were middle schoolish, huh? And so Project Lead the Way, and I'm going to step incorrectly if I do here, Penny, just a little, but when we adopted Project Lead the Way, the concept is that it starts in kindergarten and goes through 12th grade, and it'll get students involved in the hands-on, project-based component of CTE, and then, of course, you hope from there that they'll begin to narrow their approach by selecting what they're selecting in high school. But as you know, you saw some who said, hey, I'm not going to go that way, or this is going to fit into my background, but I need business, or hey, I'm looking at welding, but I probably want a business background as well, as you mentioned in the building trades. And so I think Project Leadway is the entry, going to be our entry level in the middle school that feeds the CTE component of that.
Do you think there's room to have either the high school trade, teachers, whatever, representatives or whatever, actually come in near the end of those Project Lead the Way middle school courses and say something? Does that happen or could it happen?
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm going to be very careful here because I'm kind of a blunt personality, so you probably don't know by now. I wish they would, and I wish they would do it more. And I won't go much further than that. So,
are any of the students also in, like, band? To me, like, looking at the schedule, it seems hard to fit in. You know, my son is really interested in a lot of the CTE, and he has woodshop this year and loves it. He's in band, too, but then looking at graduation requirements, he has to try to fit those in plus band, and he just couldn't do woodshop that year, even though he really wanted
on a show of hands, how many of you take advantage of the seventh hour?
At one point, yeah.
Yeah, so that I think, again, I'm stepping before my time period. Penny was here a little before me. The concept of the seventh hour was something new when I came to Midland Public, but the idea is that we have so much programming and so much choice that we have this little more flexible schedule to be able to fit in some of those electives because it is very difficult. And you know, in smaller districts, you'll see us do 0 hours. So instead of asking kids to arrive at school at 7, we're asking at 6 a.m. Not a real good thing for teenagers, right? So the concept of the seventh hour, I think, is to help them a little bit fit some of those component ends. But it is a difficult fit, I think, for some of them, and some of you would recognize. I know Sam, you're a drum major, and so he's not just in the band, but he's a leader in the band, so that balance is probably tough.
Can I say something? Me and the band, yeah, Sophia, me and Sophia, the band conflict is hard because the welding program at Midland High is provided, there's a third hour class, and then there's also a fourth hour class, and then there's a 2 hour class, fifth and sixth hour. But symphonic band, which is the band that we're both in, is fifth hour, which conflicts with the 2 hour schedule, which is the course that normally people take. And I know that some of the other programs also have conflicts with other things that are at the same hour that they're forced to choose between. So,
yeah, and off of that, Sam, you wouldn't know this component behind it. So one of the issues we'll continue to struggle with, when you build a secondary high school schedule, the worst thing you're gonna have is what's called single courses. And you would like to have multiple hours of courses so you can fit more flexibility in a student's schedule. As we've become smaller high schools, that is extremely difficult. So the amount of students who maybe choose symphonic is one period only versus maybe when we were larger, there's two. And so, you know, the balance the community will have going forward is the two high school concept and how do we share programs and hours going forward. That's going to be a real tough balance. And I won't give you my 2 cents on
Sophia,
that.
Sophia, I think you want.
So with building trades, we're finally getting 2 classes this year for third and fourth and fifth and sixth, which actually tremendously helps with the band schedule. So if you still want to be in gold or blue band or gold band, which is fourth hour, you can still take building trades fifth and sixth. But like with me, I'm in symphonic band, so I take building trades third and fourth and symphonic fifth. So yep. Having that 2 classes now really helps with, one, the building process and how much faster we can get things done, and two, it also helps a lot more with schedules, so I don't even have to even think about a seventh hour.
Yeah, that's a perfect example. So this year the enrollment was higher, and we were able to offer it multiple hours versus a single hour. So getting the bulk of enough is the difficult component of it. That was very good.
Gavin, yeah, I think we have one more comment maybe. And then I think we are out of time.
Okay, so I'm actually in the Dow High Band, and I am a section leader as well as doing all of this. And so the thing about that is I was lucky enough to have my class during fifth hour, and band at Dow was first or second hour. But the thing is now is that I have, because I'm pretty much a walking advertisement for healthcare and tech. So I've had freshmen and many other people in other grades ask me, hey, like, this is only a first hour class now because the class has pretty much been cut in half with students. And they said, what do I do? And I said, if you really think that you want to hit the ground running in the medical field, I say I would do it. Because not only would you have the opportunity to take the class and get the basic things down, you'd also have that opportunity to hopefully dual enroll in co-op. And I plan on working at my floor in the hospital while I go to college. So I say that hopefully there will be a different hour or another hour of it, but if I had to pick between one or two, I'd pick my career.
Well, we're going to end the formal part of the meeting since we're past 1 o'clock. Some of you may need to leave, but we'll stay around and answer any questions. I'm sure these students need to get back to class, but if any of them want to stay around as well, answer a question, free to do so.
Thank you, students.